Morning, church. I gotta be honest with you. I am super proud because I honestly believe that the majority of us are hungering and thirsting after God. I've seen and heard, and even in the unseen things, I know that God is working and He's moving, and I'm believing that we are intentionally seeking His face. That excites me. I wanted to say a couple of things because, intentionally seeking God, connecting with Him, disconnecting from the world for many of us is brand new. And I want to say this, God doesn't love you any more or any less than He does right now. You can't earn more of God's love if you make a commitment this week to God. And you do it. And at the end of the week, you're excited about accomplishing that. That's great, but this week is not about accomplishing a goal. This week is about drawing closer to the Father and disconnecting from the world. We have to be very careful when we pray, when we fast, when we come to church, when we lead things, when we do our morning devotions. We have to be very careful that it's not a ritual, that it's not a tradition, and that we are doing it not even to better ourselves, even though that will be the result. We're doing it to draw closer to the Father. And that's the prayer this week. And so, what happens if you have chosen to fast from something and you accidentally or even on purpose break that fast? Is God disappointed in you? Absolutely not. He's not impressed with our works. Our works are like filthy rags. He's impressed with the Christ in us. He's impressed with His Son who became our righteousness. And so while we do things, we don't do these things to impress or to earn God's favor. We do them because we love Him, because we want more of Him. And so don't put so much pressure on yourself this week. It's not about you. It's about Him. It's about the peace and the hope and the power and the trust you can have in Him that comes from Him. And so enjoy this week. Man, don't live in guilt and condemnation and shame and feel like you're going to be a failure. That is not from our Father. You hunger and thirst for Him. Do the things He leads you to do, whatever that may be. And I'm excited as you press in, as you see more of God, as He gives you more of Himself. He's going to give you the peace and the hope and the joy and the power that you're longing for. I love you, church. I continue to pray for you. Ask you to continue to pray for me and our leaders as we hunger and thirst for God more.